Welcome back to my channel and welcome if you're new here. Excuse this sweaty mess that I am. I just finished Jazzercise, but I wanted to hop on because it's Saturday. So that means it's grocery haul day. And I actually shopped again at 3 stores this week. So I have quite a large grocery haul. Last week I stocked up on all of the necessity types of things, the peanut butter, the honey, that type of thing, the flowers. Now this week I actually picked up the stuff I need for meals, lunches, snacks. So I have quite a large haul this week for you guys. I have Walmart, Trader Joe's, and Fred Meyer. All clean eating, found some new great healthy options. Can't wait to share those with you guys. So let's jump right into this week's My WW Clean Eating Grocery Haul. On a run from my given disaster, speed away from the holy mind. I just wanted to show you guys my super small pickup. I may be doing another one prior to Saturday when you see my full grocery haul, but I did have to get Diet Coke and beer for my husband, so I grabbed just a few things this pickup. So first I have another pack of the Organic California Blend. We are loving these organic vegetables. They are just a little bit more than the normal and they are so much better tasting. So I grabbed another California Blend and this one's really good. This is the multi-color cauliflower blend. So I grabbed those. Also, I was completely out of basil, so I decided just to go ahead and grab the Great Value organic basil leaves. 2 more pounds of my favorite organic grass-fed beef. This is hands down amazing. So incredibly delicious. Highly, highly recommend. Also, you guys know I like to pick up my Parmesan from Walmart because it's a lot less expensive. And then Fred Meyer doesn't carry these, and I wanted to pick up a couple. This is the Siggy's 4%, so this is whole milk yogurt. It's so good. It's so incredibly good. Here is the nutritional information here on the back. Your ingredients are absolutely amazing. Look at that. Whole milk, cream, berries, blackberries, strawberries, cane sugar, fruit pectin, live active cultures. That's it. So they are a little more smart points, but they keep you more full because they have 4% whole milk fat. So I have the mixed berry and then the vanilla. Those were the only two Walmart had, unfortunately. So I want to give both of those a try as well. So that was my small midweek Walmart grocery pickup. So here's this week's haul from Trader Joe's. I have been loving Trader Joe's for their organic produce. Best prices around here. So picked up quite a bit this week at Trader Joe's. So let's jump in. So this organic popcorn, you guys, is amazing. You can see that I've been kind of munching on it. I had it as a snack this afternoon. It is so good. It is popped with organic olive oil. And so the ingredients in this are amazing. It is organic. And look at this. This is the best popcorn you can possibly buy other than popping it yourself. Popcorn, extra virgin olive oil, salt. That's it. And you can have 3.5 cups for 4 points. And it is so delicious. This will become a new snacking staple. It's clean. It's got great ingredients and it's organic. So I saw this, thought I'd try it. And I'm so glad that I bought a bag. Wish I would have bought 2 actually. And then I got some seasoning, some cayenne pepper because I don't have any and it seems to be called for regularly in my recipes. This is a new seasoning at Trader Joe's and apparently it is flying off the shelves because it's delicious. This is everything but the Eliot. I don't know if I pronounced that right, but it's salt, chili pepper, cheese, chipotle, and cumin. Okay, I'm so excited to try this on maybe chicken or beef. Potatoes. So that is new. Again, it's flying off the shelf. So if you want to pick it up before it's gone, head to Trader Joe's. And then I also needed to get some more oregano because I was completely out of oregano. And then I grabbed this organic turkey breast that I picked up last week. This is amazing. It is so delicious. It's organic. You can see that it has no antibiotics, a vegetarian feed, free range turkey. And what I love the most about it is it's the cleanest lunch meat. Organic turkey breast, water, and salt. So I'm actually going to make a sandwich tonight for dinner with this, some cheese avocado on one of my Ezekiel English muffins. Yum. Best lunch meat option out there. It is a little pricey. This is a 6-ounce package and it's $4.99, but it tastes great and the ingredients are amazing. And then I picked up some dried cherries and this is for an upcoming recipe. I am going to count these as 0 points. because all that is in here are cherries. There is no added sugar, oil, or anything. Now you can count them as points or count them as zero, whatever your preference. I'm hardly using any in my recipe, so I'm gonna count them as zero, but dried bean cherries, you can find a lot of unsweetened fruit at Trader Joe's, which is awesome. Also, organic red potatoes. You know, potatoes are on the Dirty Dozen, and I needed them actually for several recipes. This is a 5-pound bag of baby reds. Organic Vermont maple syrup. I forgot to pick up maple syrup at Costco, and you guys, this was $5 at Trader Joe's. It's organic, and it's real Vermont maple syrup, and look, all that's in it is maple syrup. So I picked that up. I'm gonna be needing this for some upcoming recipes. Also, I've been wanting to try to find a rice cake that I can have as a snack that has good ingredients with some nut butter or, I mean, really anything on there. You could put some hummus. So this is the Lundberg Organic Whole Grain Rice Cakes, brown rice, lightly salted. These are organic, of course. And then look at these ingredients. I was like, oh, finally, organic brown rice and sea salt. They're only 2 smart points a piece. So I'm excited that I found these. I cannot wait to have these as a snack, again, with some peanut butter or maybe some hummus. You could even put some of that turkey and melt it on there with some cheese. Yum. So I grabbed that. 2 containers of organic free-range chicken broth so that I just have these on hand. Again, I was watching my ingredients and these had the best ingredients of all chicken broths. Be careful because a lot of them have chicken flavor and that's not actually real chicken. So I wanted to make sure that I picked one up that didn't have chicken flavor or natural flavor. Everything else is produce. I've been buying a lot of produce since I switched my eating. So I have a big pack here of 2 pounds of organic strawberries. Again, those are on the Dirty Dozen, so you definitely want those in organic. A big red onion, 2 shallots, 2 bananas. I need one for a recipe, and then I thought I'd just have an extra for snacking. 2 mangoes for meal prep. Tricolor peppers. These are the organic tricolor. $4.99 at Trader Joe's for an orange, yellow, and red organic pepper. This is a killer deal. These are organic Brussels sprouts. This is a huge bag. This is a 2-pound bag, and they're $3.99. She said that these are a special buy, and they won't be around for long, but the smaller bag, half the size, is a dollar more. So great price for organic Brussels sprouts. I'm going to roast these up, which is actually my very favorite way to eat them. And I feel like I might want to go back and get another bag. And then I have some organic lemons here for my water and recipes. And then this is another thing I grab for smoothies. This is the unsweetened acai puree packs. They are individual little packs of acai. And all that is in here is the actual fruit. So I'm gonna be counting these 0 as well. I do not count blended fruit. And these will be put into my smoothie in place of frozen fruit. And lastly, for smoothies and for recipes, power to the greens, organic baby kale, chard, and spinach. So that's everything for the week from Trader Joe's. So here's my grocery haul from Fred Meyer or Kroger. So I just finished up the last few things I needed after Walmart and Trader Joe's. So first I'm gonna show you the non-food items that I picked up, and then we'll jump into the food for this week. So I saw these and they were half off and I could not pass them up. These are a Bohemian collection of measuring cups, and look at how cute these are. They stack. Look at it. They're so cute. I had to get them. And in that same line, they had this really pretty wooden bowl that was also half off. So I picked that up. I really like that whole bohemian vibe. And then I grabbed just a single ball jar. This is for my nutritional yeast that I bought at Natural Grocers because it comes in a bag that is non-resealable. So I'm going to throw it in a ball jar just to kind of keep it a little bit more fresh. And the rest of what I picked up is food. So in the bulk section, I went ahead and grabbed some currants, and I need this for an upcoming recipe. And again, when I need just a small amount of something, I always hit up my bulk section. This was less than a dollar, so this is just enough for the recipe. I also needed some flax meal for smoothies and recipes. This is in the refrigerated section. This is the organic golden flaxseed from Bob's Red Mill. It is also gluten-free, so all that is in here is organic whole golden flax. So I picked that up for, again, recipes and smoothies. And then I heard about these tortillas on Flav City, and these are a very clean tortilla and a great dupe for the ole wrap. These are two smart points for the large tortilla. They also carry a small one that is one smart point. These are non-GMO, certified organic, and the ingredients, you guys, are the best for tortillas that literally I've pretty much ever seen. I mean, there is nothing in these tortillas that is not considered a clean ingredient. They even use expeller pressed oil, which is the best option. So this is a full size tortilla, about the same as an ole wrap. A million times better ingredients and two smart points instead of one. I will take the extra smart point for a much better quality ingredient tortilla. Little bummed out about the Campbell's French onion soup. I looked for an organic version of French onion. They did not have any. This does not have very good ingredients. So it just happens to be in a recipe that I had planned. I will no longer be making recipes that have this type of soup in it because I really don't want to have to use it if I don't have to, just because the ingredients aren't that great. And then I grabbed a can of organic Great Northern beans. This is for a recipe. And also a can of pineapple for a recipe. Not worried so much about pineapple being organic. It is one of the items on the Clean 15. So if you have not seen that video, I'll put it here at the end on my end screen for you. But the Clean 15 is fruits and vegetables that you don't necessarily have to buy organic, and pineapple falls on that list. And then you saw me haul last week the other Picnic brand of collagen creamer. This is the Picnic vegan creamer, and this is also made with coconut cream and MCT oil. Great option for a creamer for your coffee. Really, really good ingredients. And you can have a quarter cup for one smart point. And this you can find in the organic section of your local grocery store. Also, I grabbed some new milk. I was so excited to see this. I will probably make my own almond milk, and I'll be showing that to you guys in an upcoming video, but I have never seen this at my store. This is certified organic, dairy-free cashew milk, unsweetened. And you guys, look at this. I mean, it is 50 calories for an entire cup, and here are your ingredients. There is nothing artificial in this whatsoever. It's a great replacement for almond milk. So if you can find the Forager brand in your store, highly recommend. I want to say it was about $6, so it's a little bit more, almost double your traditional almond milk, but a million times better ingredients. Also, these are a very clean chip. They have all types of flavors. They've got your regular tortilla chips. I've seen nacho. I went ahead and grabbed the lime. These are made with avocado oil. These are called Siete grain-free tortilla chips. I did scan them when I was in the store. They are 5 smart points per serving, and a serving is 9 chips. But look at these ingredients. I mean, you can't get cleaner than this. Cassava flour, avocado oil, coconut flour, ground chia, sea salt, citric acid, and lime oil. Yeah. Amazing, amazing, amazing. $4.49 a bag. Really not much more than regular chips, and excellent ingredients. So I'm just gonna have these with some of that cheese sauce that I got last week. Oh my gosh, I'm so excited for that. And then the rest of what I picked up is produce. So I picked up a huge bag of organic mango chunks. I am going to be having a smoothie video coming out where I'm gonna show you guys tons of clean eating smoothies, and I'm going to make those throughout this week. So I want to have that video up in the next couple weeks for you. So a lot of this is for that smoothie video. So mango chunks, I would have gotten the smaller bag, but they just didn't have any, and I only wanted organic. And then I have some organic raspberries and organic blueberries. Also some fresh blueberries from Simple Truth Organic, just to have on hand for fruits this week. Some organic bananas. This is for snacking as well as for the smoothie video. 2 huge packs, 2 pounds of organic white mushrooms. I really wanted Baby Bell, but they didn't have any of those. Baby Bella. They didn't have any of those at Fred Meyer. So Costco is a steal for organic mushrooms, but I need these for a recipe. 4 organic zucchinis for a recipe, an organic navel orange for a recipe, and then let's talk kale. So this kale may look a little bizarre to you. You're probably more used to seeing the kale that looks similar to parsley. This kale has a lot different texture. This is much better for eating, like in salads. And it's also excellent for kale chips because you can see that there's huge, I mean, the leaves of this kale are huge, and it's great for smoothies. So I picked this up just to put in my smoothie. This is what it's called. This is the La Centenado kale, and this is an organic kale as well. Kale is almost the dirtiest vegetable on the Dirty Dozen, so highly recommend buying your kale or organic, whether it's frozen or fresh. Again, that video will be linked at the end of this one. So big bunch of kale, was $2. So I'll definitely go through that between salads and smoothies. So that's everything that I picked up for the week. And now let's jump into this week's meal plan and meal prep. All right, let's jump into this week's meal plan. This is the week of February 22nd through February 28th. I can't believe February is almost over. And if you haven't joined my Facebook group, head over and join us so you can sign up for March's meal plan. Clean eating, delicious recipes. Don't miss out on that. So Saturday today, we will be going out to dinner. It is the day that I use my weeklies. Sunday, I'm going to be making balsamic glazed chicken. You guys will see this recipe in my What I Eat in a Day, so stay tuned for that. Monday is always a leftovers night because I go to Jazzercise. Tuesday, I'm going to be making French onion meatballs. I'm really excited about these as well. Wednesday will be leftovers again. It's a Jazzercise night. Thursday is mushroom risotto. Now, this sounds really good. I'm probably going to pair this with chicken, I would imagine, but I'm really excited about this recipe. And then Friday, I'm going to be making a roast in my crock pot with carrots and potatoes and all the things. So that is what is up for dinners for this week. On the back, I usually write down what I'm doing for meal prep. So let's go over that next. So for breakfast this week, I'm going to be making an oatmeal cookie baked oatmeal. I know it sounds sweet and indulgent and bad for you, but this is going to be clean eating and it's going to be delicious. Stay tuned for all three of these recipes in Monday's meal prep. Lunches this week is a Jamaican chicken sheet pan dinner. I'm really excited for this too. It has mango and chicken and tons of vegetables. And then for a snack this week, I'm really excited. I'm going to be making a homemade granola bar. Clean ingredients, low points, so good. So all of these recipes will be shown in Monday's meal prep. So that is meal prep for the week and my dinners for the upcoming week. And now let's take a quick look at our Carryell meal planner. So this is the meal planner that I use. This is the Carryell. You guys know I love, love, love this. This is the black and white cover in size 8.5 by 11. There's a link for this down in the description box below, as well as 10% off. So definitely check that out. So this is essentially what the meal planner looks like. It's beautiful, you guys. It's absolutely gorgeous. You have tabs for several areas as far as tracking and planning your meals. So first is the resources tab, and that's where you can jot down your favorite meal planning blogs and recipe sites, just so they're at a glance when you're planning your meals and your grocery list for the week. There's also the inventory tab, and that's where you can inventory your freezer, your pantry, and you can also inventory your spices. So that's really nice. Of course, there's a meal planning tab. We'll return to that one. Next up is gatherings, and that's where you can plan events. So you can write down the event, you can plan all of your food as well as what you're doing for kids and supplies. And then that also comes with the detachable grocery list so that you can take that to the store to stock your event. So I love this. I've used this several times. And then lastly is the notes section, and that's just a place for you to take notes. Again, I've used this several times. I've torn pages out. I actually love this meal planner. I use all the pieces of it. And then in the back, there's this cute little two-sided folder here. What I do is put my recipes for the week in that folder so that they're easy on hand. So now let's actually get into the meal plan tab. So in the meal plans tab, you're going to have a monthly at-a-glance calendar where you can write down your meals. Now you guys can track breakfast, lunch, dinner, snacks, whatever you want to track. I only write in my dinners because I meal prep breakfast, lunch, and snacks. So those are the same throughout the week. So my dinners is where I write into the little spaces here. So what I can do the night before is, one, make sure my meat is out of the freezer for the next night's dinner. And two, I have all of the ingredients on hand so that when I go to make dinner, all of a sudden I don't have all the ingredients, because that really is not fun. So I use the monthly meal planner every single month. It just really kind of helps me plan my meals for the week and or for the month, and everything is at a glance. And then you also receive the weekly menu. So we just went over this week, so you'll see that my grocery list is missing because I use it every week when I go to the grocery store. You can certainly write down, again, breakfast, lunch, dinner, snacks. You'll track it for the week, and then you have a detachable grocery list that you'll tear off and take with you to the store. So love it so much. You can see I'm almost done. I think this is it. Few more pages before I go into my new meal planner for 2020. So again, this is the carry-on meal planner. Down in the description box, I do have a link for 10% off. You have to actually click the link in the description box and enter my code at checkout to get 10%. And that is good for anything on the Carrie L site. Highly recommend, you guys. It's going to make your journey so much easier. Thank you for joining me on this week's grocery haul. Whew, that was a lot of groceries again, but I am stocked up for the week. I have such good recipes that I'm ready to share. And also, speaking of recipes and sharing, if you have not joined my Facebook group, there is a link down in the description box. Come on over and take advantage of being part of my meal plan service that I offer. I plan all of your meals for you for an entire month with a couple of days for leftovers, but you've got 20 dinner recipes, 4 breakfasts, 4 lunches, 4 snacks, and any bonus recipes that I decide to throw in. So head on over if you're struggling with recipes or you wanna maybe transition to clean eating, my recipes will definitely help get you there. Also, if you're new, welcome. I'd love it if you take a moment, hit that subscribe button and the little bell. That way you're just notified whenever a new video is uploaded. That way you don't miss a single one. Thumbs up this video if you love grocery hauls and leave your comments down below. Let me know what you thought of some of my new finds and if you have found any great clean eating things I need to know about. Thank you guys so much for watching, and of course, I'll see you next time.